Hello my dear students, in this lecture we are going to see one numerical on eccentrically loaded riveted joint. Now the question is, the bracket attached to the vertical column by means of four identical rivets. The meaning of four identical rivets is that all the rivets will be having same size, that is same diameter, is subjected to an eccentric force of 25 kN as shown in figure. See here, these four identical rivets are subjected to eccentric force of 25 kN at distance 100 mm, eccentricity is 100 mm. Determine the diameter of rivet if permissible shear stress is 60 Newton per mm square. Now here the force P is 25 kN, eccentricity is 100 mm, permissible shear stress means maximum shear stress, which is nothing but SSY divided by factor of safety, is 60 Newton per mm square. This is given data. Now question is to find diameter of rivet. Diameter is the question, right? Now because of this force P, the rivets are subjected to primary shear load as well as P into E. It is acting as a torque, therefore they are subjected to torsion, that means secondary shear loads. Now for these four bolt rivets, we can say centroid will be at in between, exactly at center of 2 and 3. Therefore, can I say the centroid of these four bolt rivets will be at some this location G, right? Now let us consider these rivets. Therefore, if I consider rivet number 1, then rivet number 2, rivet number 3 and rivet number 4, all rivets are identical, means having same size. Now distance between all the rivets is given, distance between all the rivets is 100 mm and centroid will be at this location. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Now therefore from centroid, now we can say from centroid, the distance of rivet 1 is R1. Therefore, we can say this distance is R1, radius 1, right? And this distance will be, can I say, here this will be 50, that is half of 100, and this is 100. Now again, this is 50 and this is 100. These distances are given, means R1 is equal to 150 mm. Similarly, R2, here distance between centroid and rivet 2, this distance is R2. Therefore, can I say R2 is equal to 50 mm? We can say here R2 is equal to 50 mm. As well as distance of rivet 3 from centroid, this distance is called R3. Therefore, R3 is equal to 50 mm. As well as distance of centroid from the rivet 4, this distance is R4. Therefore, R4 will be equal to again 150 mm. Therefore, we have calculated distance of all the rivets from the centroid. That is, we can say R1 is equal to R4 is equal to 150 mm. And R2 is equal to R3 is equal to 50 mm. Now, let us consider all these rivets. Here the force P, which is of 25 kN, we can directly transfer at centroid of rivets, but along with this force we have to transfer the torque created by this force about that centroid. Therefore, directly put this force of 25 kN on centroid, but along with this force we have to transfer the torque. Torque is nothing but P into E, which is nothing but 25 into 100 kN mm. This torque also we need to transfer at centroid. Hence, consider the rivets. Let us say here rivet 1, then rivet 2, then rivet 3 and rivet 4. These are the four rivets, and for these four rivets the centroid will be at this location, and on centroid we can put the force P. in vertically downward direction, which is acting in vertical downward direction of magnitude 25 kN, as well as we can put torque T, and torque T is nothing but 25 into 100 kN mm. Right. Now, in all the rivets, that is rivet 1, 2, 3 and 4, there will be a primary shear load in the direction opposite to this 25 kN. Therefore, let us say in rivet 4, PS4, rivet 3, equal and opposite, in upward direction, PS3, rivet 2, there will be PS2, and in rivet 1, there will be PS1. And where PS1 is primary shear load in rivet 1, and similarly PS2, PS3, PS4 are in both rivet 2, rivet 3, rivet 4. And we have derived already, the primary shear load in all the rivets is same, that is PS1 is equal to PS2 is equal to PS3 is equal to PS4, which is nothing but total load divided by number of rivets, that is 4, which is nothing but 25 divided by 4. Therefore, PS1 is equal to PS2 is equal to PS3 is equal to PS4 is equal to 6.25 kN. These are the primary shear loads acting in all the rivets in vertically upward direction. Now, let us find secondary shear loads. Now, secondary shear loads are to cancel this clockwise torque here. Torque is acting in clockwise direction. Therefore, to cancel this clockwise torque, there will be a secondary shear load in all the rivets. And as torque is acting in clockwise direction at G, here this point is G, at G, torque is acting in clockwise direction. Hence, to cancel this clockwise torque, we need to apply anti-clockwise torque on all the four rivets. And torque is nothing but force into perpendicular radius. Now, let us find the secondary shear load in all the rivets. Now, distance of G from rivet 1 is called R1. And the secondary shear load will be perpendicular to this radius. Which must create anti-clockwise torque. Therefore, there will be secondary shear load in rivet 1 like this, PS1 dash. PS1 dash is secondary shear load. As well as at R2 or at rivet 2, that is from G to center of rivet 2, there will be secondary shear load in anti-clockwise direction, perpendicular radius. Therefore, PS2 dash will be like this, PS2 dash, perpendicular to radius, perpendicular to radius. Now, and at rivet 3, that is at distance R3, this distance is R3, right, and perpendicular to this radius, the secondary shear load, PS3 dash, which must create anti-clockwise torque about G. Again, at radius R4, that is center of rivet 4, there will be perpendicular to this radius, PS4 dash. PS4 dash, right, these are perpendiculars. Now, we know that this PS1 dash is equal to KR1, where K is nothing but, let us find first K value. Constant is equal to P into E divided by R1 square plus R2 square plus R3 square plus R4 square. Therefore, K is equal to P is nothing but 25 kN into 10 to the power 3. It will become in Newton. This is P. Eccentricity is 100 divided by R1 is 150 square plus R2 is 50 square plus R3 is 50 square plus R4 is 150 square that we already calculated. Therefore, this K becomes equal to 50. The value of constant is 50. Now, we can say the secondary shear load in bolt rivet 1, PS1 dash is equal to KR1, which is nothing but 50 into R1 is 150. Therefore, PS1 dash is equal to, we can find PS1 dash equal to 7500 Newton. Again, similarly, we can find PS2 dash. PS2 dash is equal to KR2, which is nothing but 50 into 50, which is nothing but 2500 Newton, right, PS2 dash is equal to 2500 Newton. Again, similarly, PS3 dash is equal to, we can say PS2 dash, because R2 is equal to R3, R2 is equal to R3 is equal to 50 mm, R1 is equal to R4 is equal to 150 mm, therefore PS3 dash is equal to PS2 dash is equal to 250 Newton. Similarly, PS4 dash is equal to PS1 dash is equal to KR1 or KR4, which is nothing but 7500 Newton. Right. These are the secondary shear loads. And the primary shear load, PS1 is equal to PS2 is equal to PS3 is equal to PS4 is equal to 6.25 kilonewton, means it is 6250 Newton in Newtons. Right. Now, consider any one rivet. If I consider rivet 1, then on rivet 1, let us consider rivet 1. On this rivet, there is a primary shear load PS1 which is of magnitude 6250 Newton, and there is secondary shear load which is of magnitude PS1 dash equal to 7500 Newton, and they are mutually perpendicular to each other because of geometry. Therefore, their resultant will lie in between them. The resultant will lie in between them, which is nothing but P1. And to find resultant for perpendicular loads, that is, we can say P1 is equal to under root of PS1 square plus PS1 dash square. Right. Now, my dear students, primary shear load in all the rivets is same. And secondary shear load in rivet 1, PS1 dash, and rivet 4, PS4 dash are maximum. Maximum, you can see here, this is PS3 dash and PS2 dash and PS4 dash and PS1 dash. PS1 dash and PS4 dash are maximum. Therefore, as PS1 dash is maximum for rivet 1 and rivet 4, therefore we can say the rivet 4 and rivet 1 are critically loaded. And our design must be for critical loading only. Let us find the resultant load in all the rivets. Therefore, for first rivet, there will be PS1, which is acting in vertical direction, which is nothing but 6250 Newton, and PS1 dash towards left, which is nothing but 7500. Therefore, resultant on rivet 1, that is P1, we can say P1 is equal to under root of PS1 square plus PS1 dash square, which is nothing but P1 is equal to under root of 6250 square plus 7500 square. Now find this P1. Then this resultant load you will find as 9762.81 Newton. Now again, due to symmetry, if I look at the bolt 4 on, sorry, rivet 4, because here it is a riveted joint. Now PS4 is of same magnitude, which is nothing but 7500, and PS4 dash is 7500, and PS4 is also 6250. Now the resultant of these two will lie in between, which is nothing but P4. Again, same formula will come, that is P4 is equal to under root of 7500 square plus 6250 square. Therefore, P1 is equal to P4. Due to symmetry, P1 is equal to P4. Resultant load on rivet 1 and 4 is same. Similarly, the resultant load on rivet 2 and rivet 3 will be same, because see, PS2 and PS2 dash, PS3 which is upward, PS3 which is upward here, right, and PS3 dash are same, and again angle between them is 90 degree. Therefore, resultant we can say here there will be P2 and here there will be P3. Resultant will be in between, and PS2 is equal to PS2 is equal to PS3, and PS2 dash is equal to PS3 dash. Therefore, resultant formula will come same, which is the same under root of PS2 square plus PS2 dash square, which is nothing but PS3 square plus PS3 dash square. Therefore, P2 is equal to P3, which is nothing but under root of PS2 is calculated 6250 square plus PS2 dash is 2500 whole square. Therefore, calculate resultant load on bolt or rivet 2 and rivet 3. P2 is equal to P3 is equal to 6731.45 Newton. Now, from this we can say P1 is equal to P4. This value is more than P2 is equal to P2 and P3, right? Therefore, rivet 1 and rivet 4 are critical loaded. Therefore, the design must be for rivet 1 and rivet 4. Let us consider rivet 1. Now, resultant load on P1 is equal to, we have just calculated, 9762.81 newton, which is nothing but resultant shear stress or shear load, resultant shear load. Therefore, because of this shear load, there will be maximum shear stress in the rivet, which is nothing but shear load divided by area. Now, what is area? Here, can I say P1 divided by pi by 4 d square? Therefore, the P, we can say here, maximum shear stress is already given in the given data. This maximum shear stress value is already given, which is nothing but 60. You can check the given data. Is equal to P1 we have calculated. This 4 will go up into 9762.81 divided by pi into d square. Now here, in this equation, only diameter is unknown. Now let us solve for diameter. Therefore, if I find diameter, I will get 14.39 mm answer. And this is your answer for gate examination. Thank you, dear students. In next lecture, we will see one more numerical on riveted joint.